Good morning, dear students. Welcome in your English class. Before starting today's class, let's see what's the date today. Today's date is 19th February, okay? And in our last classes, we have completed the writing skill section. That is, we have done the letter writing, both letter writing, that is informal letter also, and the application also, okay? And I have given you a homework, and most of you have sent me the homework in at my WhatsApp number, but still many of you have not done the homework. Please do it and send it on my number. Is it clear? And in paragraph writing, we have done two paragraphs, that is a morning walk and a spring season. Is it clear? So we have already completed the literature course and the writing skill section for our annual examination. Now let's move on to the grammar section. You all know that in grammar we are having three chapters, that are lesson 13, 14 and 15. Okay, lesson 13, 14 and 15. Lesson 13 is from our unit test course. Okay, it is from our unit second course. Now we are left with two lessons, that is lesson 14 and 15. Today we are going to start with lesson 14, that is the past continuous tense. Okay, so let's start our today's class. Okay, now before starting the past continuous tense, let us recall what is present continuous tense. While teaching present continuous tense, I have given you a formula that we are going to discuss here. First of all, the past continuous tense. What is the past continuous tense? Continuous means anything which is going on. At the time of present continuous tense also, I have explained you the same thing. The action which is going on comes under continuous form. Is it clear? So present continuous was that the action is still going on. That is present continuous tense. What is past continuous tense? That means in past also the action was still going on. That is the past continuous tense. Let's see some example. I was watching television. I was watching television. This is a sentence which is in past form. How you can say the sentence is in past form? Because it is having was. Was is a helping verb which is used in past form, past tense. Okay. If I write this sentence in present form, what will be? I am watching television. I am watching television. This is present continuous tense. And what is the past continuous tense? I was watching television. Both the things are same. Watching, watching. That means the verb is same in the same form. Only the helping verb has changed. Remember, in present continuous tense, I have said to use is, am, are plus verb first form plus ing. Remember, this was in present continuous tense. Present continuous tense. Now, what will be in the past continuous tense? What will be the formula? Instead of is and am, we are going to use was. And instead of are, we are going to use were. So, what formula we have derived? Was or were plus this thing will be same. Verb first form plus ing. This is past continuous tense. Is it clear? Simple is that. The action is still going on in the past. Okay. And instead of is or am, we are going to use was, and instead of are, we are going to use were. That is, the formula is was or were plus verb first form plus ing. This is the formula for past continuous tense. Let's see many more examples. Let me clear the board. So let us write here, was or were plus verb first form plus ing. Okay, this is the formula for past continuous tense. Now you will ask me, ma'am, where to use was and where to use were. Similarly, like in present continuous tense, we use is for singular person, am for I, and are for plural person. Here also, was for singular person, were for plural person. Okay, now what are singular person? Let's recall, I is a single person. Yes, because I don't require any help. I is a single person. I, then he, she, it. All these are single person or any name. Is it clear? Now come to plural person. What are plural person? You, because you can be a single person to whom I'm talking, or you can be the whole class. Okay, so you, they, and we, or many names, means many people are together, many names. So this is plural person. Is it clear? Single person means I, he, she, it, or any single name, and plural person will be you, they, we, or many names. Like if I say a name of 2-3 friends together, that A, B, and C was going? No, it will be were going. Is it clear? So, what we have derived the formula was or were plus verb first form plus ing. That means verb first form is what? Eat, sleep, cook, any verb which is in its first form. And ing is cooking, sleeping, eating, writing, any verb plus ing. Verb should be in its base form. This thing is clear, the concept is clear. Now let's see what are the exercises. But before that, I will tell you one more thing, that past continuous tense also resembles one more thing. What do you know? When one action was done, the previous action was still going on. Like suppose I entered the room, this action has been done by me. I entered the room when the boy was playing. I entered the room when the boy was playing. That means the action was going on. This is the past continuous tense. That is, the boy was playing. Was playing. I am telling about my past. That at that time when I entered the room, the boy was playing. Is it clear? So I entered the room. That means one action has been done when already the previous action was going on. So let us take more example. Father came home when mother was cooking. it is not necessary that the past continuous form will always be at the back. I can write like mother was cooking. When father came home. Okay, is it clear? So it doesn't matter, it hardly matters that this form, past continuous tense, will be in the back part of the sentence or in the front part. It doesn't matter. But it is showing that one action is already going on when the other action took place. I think by the example it is clear and it is very simple. No need to worry. Just keep in mind was or were plus verb first form plus ing. Where to use was? With single person. And where to use were? With plural person. Is it clear? So let's move on to exercises. Now take out your grammar book. This is your grammar book. Please take it out and open page number 71. This is the chapter, the past continuous tense, and today we are going to solve the exercises. See, there are A, B, C and D. Four exercises are there. 1-1, 2-2 example of all the exercises I'm going to discuss here. And after that, I will send the remaining exercises at your WhatsApp while taking the class so that you can solve it easily. Is it clear? Now let's move on to the first exercise. A. Fill in the blanks with the past continuous form of the verb given in the bracket. See here, some sentences are given here and in bracket some verbs are given like dance, sit, cook, look, remove, practice, have. All the verbs are given here and we have to fill these blanks with past continuous form. So let's continue. People dash in the street. What is the verb given? Dance. Now first thing, how to do this type of exercises? Just listen to me very carefully. People dash in the street. People dash in the street. What is the verb? Dance. Now, before going to verb, let's see people. People is the subject and what is the subject? Single person or plural person? People, it can be many people. So, people, many people, what will be? Were, because it is plural subject given here. People were. Now, verb first form is given here and what we have to do? Add ing. So, people were dancing. People were dancing in the street. Clear? Now, let's see another example. I dash in my bedroom. In my bedroom. In my bedroom, reading a book. Reading a book. I dash in my bedroom reading a book. Now see subject. Subject is I. I is a single person. For single person, I was. I was sitting in my bedroom reading a book. Clear? Now let's see the third one. Mother dash the dinner when I got home. Cook. Mother, single person is there, so mother was the dinner when I got home. Cook, cooking. Mother was cooking the dinner when I got home. Is it clear? So you have understood how you have to solve these types of exercises. You have to see the subject first. Then with the subject, you will relate whether to use was or whether to use were. After means getting was or were, nothing is left. You have to just add ing to the word given. Cooking, dancing, sitting, eating, looking, removing, whatever be the verb, you have to just add ing, but you have to give more emphasis on was or were. How you will see? By looking at the subject. So there are 7 questions in part A. I have discussed 3. The remaining I am going to send you at your WhatsApp number in the WhatsApp group. Okay. Now let's discuss exercise B. Fill up with was or were. This thing to right now I have discussed how you have to do, so I will discuss it only 2. Okay, one is we dash the champions last year. Second one, Lena dash cleaning the room . Okay, 2 we are going to discuss, remaining I will send you. We is what? Plural person, so we were the champions last year. Lena is a single subject, so Lena was cleaning the room. Is it clear? I hope you have no confusion. If I will not send you, then also you can do it. I think this much confidence I am having. Okay, but I will send it, don't worry. Now let's move to third exercise. Turn your page number 72, and let's see exercise C. Rewrite the following sentences correctly. That means 5 sentences are given here and some or the other mistake is there in the sentence. First, let us detect what is the mistake and then we have to rectify it. Okay, let's see the first example. Nishi was ran in the race. Nishi was ran in the race. Let's go to the formula first. Was or were. Nishi is a single subject. So, Nishi was or were. We will use was. So, this thing is correct. Nishi was. Okay. Now, were. What is the base form of ran? It will be run. Base form is run. We got the base form. Now it is written, add ing to the base form. Here ing is added? No. It is written ran. Base form is run. So it will be running. Running. So the correct sentence will be, Nishi was running in the race. Is it clear? Nishi was running in the race. Now let's see the second sentence. Medha were making paper boats. Medha were making paper boats. Now let's see. Medha is a single subject. Medha were. No, were is wrong. Making correct. So the correct sentence will be Medha was making paper boats. Is it clear? All the other things are correct, but instead of were we are going to use was, because Medha is a single subject. Now it's clear. Now let's move to the last exercise, that is exercise B. Last exercise is true or false. So let's see what is true or false. The past continuous tense deals with the event that express continuation in the past. It is true. Second one, an event in a past continuous sentence does not show its beginning or end. Yes, it is true. Because the action is still going on, I don't know when the action is going to end and I don't know when the action has been started. So the ending and the starting is not means clear in continuous form. So an event in a past continuous sentence does not show its beginning or end. Is it clear? So both the sentences are true. The present continuous and the past continuous tenses do not differ from each other in any way. No, they are differ in which form? In the form of helping verb only. But there is a difference. Then only they are having two different names, that is past continuous and present continuous. So the sentence is false. The third one is false. The present continuous and the past continuous tense do not differ from each other in any way. No, this is false. In form of helping verb, they are different. Okay, remaining part is same, but helping verb differs. Now, was and were are used as the helping verbs of the past continuous tense. Yes, this is true. Now, last, has and have are used with the plural subject in past continuous sentence. No, has and have are used in present tense, not in past tense. In past tense, for has and have, we use had, not has or have. So this sentence is false. So by this, we have completed the lesson past continuous tense, and the lesson is very easy. I hope everything is clear to you. I hope you will complete your work without any doubt. Okay. The remaining part of the exercises I'm going to send you in at the WhatsApp group. Now, one more thing. Many students have not submitted the project. 15th Feb was the date for 5th A. Then 17th was for 5th B. And 18th was for 5th C. Still many students have not sent the work. Please send your projects, because you are having marks in it. That is the grades are there. Is it clear? That's all for today. Thank you students. Please complete your work and have a nice day.